What up, everybody? Mean Boys back with a new episode.
Yeah, we got Nicole Buchanan in the trap with us today.
What? Fireworks.
Call forward.
Yeah, yeah.
bring in the late Razzle Dazzle.
You guys are going to find out about my new business I'm starting. A lot of stuff about, cereal. It's a good episode. A lot is covered.
Yeah, Bed Bath and Behurtling Towards the Grave, I think should be the name of that business.
Yes. What do we say in these things? I don't remember.
We generally plug things like the Discord, and the Reddit.
And the subreddit. You know, you can discuss things with your fellow Mean Boys fans. Links for those in the show notes below.
We have a Patreon, which we've been angrily reminded many times this month.
Yeah, we have a Patreon page. More of the $25 boxes went out because you guys got us your t-shirt sizes. If you haven't done that, do that already if you paid for it in the last few months.
Almost everything is caught up. We're waiting on a few t-shirt sizes who didn't get back to us. But other than that, we've got everything sent out. Everything's groovy.
Yep, and it's all coming down the pipes. We'll get there, guys. We're sorry.
We're caught up. We got a big boy job, and we're all fucking falling behind here.
Yeah, so it's $5 a month, weekly bonus content, $10 a month, monthly goodies. You guys already know the damn drill.
Yeah, you know what's up. Not a ton to plug, really.
Not a ton else to discuss.
Yeah. I also have a $25 box. My box.
Oh, what? What are you going to get it 2.5 times?
When'd you raise the price? It was 20 last week.
Pay $25 and you can come down my pipes.
Weirdly, it's cheaper for the ass.
If you're 26, you get the extra most boxist. It's got more cheese and pepperoni than the classic box.
Comes with a Baja Blast.
Have you guys heard of they have this new pill that makes your cum smell good or taste good?
It's called a pineapple.
No, well... Is that true?
That's the only way Keith can get it down is if he swallows it without tasting it. He just goes, fruit.
I just think it's hilarious. Like, you can have,
hold
like,
his nose.
Strawberry-flavored gum.
Ah,
is that real? There's no way that is healthy.
The schlongberries taste like schlongberries.
It's a new pill.
And they're our sponsor this week. Use promo code Nicole's Pussy
to get 50% off your box.
That's pullout.
Yeah. Well, I think we've
done all the important business for the show.
Yeah.
Enjoy. Hey everybody, welcome to the Mean Boys Podcast. Piss jugs are self-care. I'm Connor McSpadden.
I'm Keith Carey.
And I'm
a lady bumming smokes at a trailer park.
Yay!
That's with the jorts. You look like you're the fun lady outside of a Circle K.
Oh God, I didn't even realize the jorts had spread.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It's hot outside, okay?
Oh no, I'm jealous of everyone's jort game.
I think you could pull off jorts. You should wear these.
Like a full Daisy Duke, yes. like pockets out the bottom.
Absolutely.
Kind of situation.
What makes you say that?
Because it would be funny.
me in any article of clothing besides just something bland and one color is hilarious.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah.
You do bring a lot of, you do bring a lot of Z-axis to the things you wear.
I have a hilarious amount of, puffed up hunk.
Well, now I'm picturing, I can picture you in jorts, but not you. I picture you in more like the short, like tennis short type things, you know?
Okay. I could wear like some, some old school basketball shorts.
Yes.
But like jorts... jorts, if you can't fill them out a little bit.
Yeah, you gotta be a little thick.
You gotta be able to put a little bit of pressure on those jorts.
Well, a fat guy in jorts looks like, sort of fun and charming and look, let's go mudding, brother. But like a thin guy in jorts looks like a criminal.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He looks like he's about to get nailed on cops.
Well, you gotta have an ass.
Thin guy in jorts used to live in a different town but moved because of a rape case.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
Do you have an ass, Connor?
I did. It got popped at some point. I don't really know what happened.
Ass.
I used to have a pretty popping little ass, but now I've got it's flat and there's just two little sub wrinkles underneath it.
Yeah.
Know what I mean?
I've been trying to do, this 30-day butt challenge and it's not working.
Okay. What's the challenge?
Oh, it's you keep putting things of different sizes.
You only eat butt for 30 days.
It's like to be
one of these new crash diets the kids are doing.
You're gauging your butthole like a sad girl's earrings.
Yeah. It's squats and shit. Like okay. squats and fire hydrants okay. and
what's a fire hydrant?
It's
is that where
exactly.
you come on a guy's face and you,
no.
and you clench
it's when
it
you're
unclench.
Down on all fours and you lift your leg up like you're about to pee on a fire hydrant like a dog.
That's literally the name of the exercise.
Yeah,
is that like used? Does like everybody mm-hmm. say that?
I think
that's
so.
Not just like a fun slang.
Well, the original name was calling it a piss bitch.
Yeah. Oh, shit. No, what we should call it is a $130 ticket. I'm going to tell you about...
By the way, when you said piss Welcome. Jugs, I immediately thought of, like, jugs, like boobs.
Oh, like tits full of piss.
Oh, tits yeah. with piss all over?
Yeah.
Wait, that's not where you keep your piss?
Yeah.
I thought girls' piss was stored in the boobs. Which is why I assume Nicole's been dehydrated for most of her life.
I'm just picturing somebody lactating pee and it comes out steamy.
No, my new campaign is to rebrand piss jugs as self care for guys.
Hmm. How is it self?
It's like the opposite of self care.
Because
no, it
you're
is.
Not taking the time to walk to a bathroom.
No, it's self care because you know sometimes you're cozy. You know you're watching your favorite show, and you know maybe you're watching the basketball game on our NBA streams.
Okay.
And then you start thinking streams. That gives me an idea. and then you piss in a jug so you don't miss any of the cool basketball action.
It's
self care. It's taking. It's just allowing yourself to be gross, because that's what you need right now.
I think pissing in a jug is fine for self-care, but getting rid of the piss jug later in the day is also part of self-care.
I'm surprised you haven't just cut a hole in your bed with a bucket underneath so you don't have to get out of bed to pee.
Making a water bed?
Well, gotta change the oil. That would be cool. Then I could have like a whole kiddie pool full of piss that I pull out like a shelf.
Like,
yeah.
like one of those industrial bags of soup. Like just a big zip.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like
piss.
Like how it shows up to the fucking Panera Bread. You
they
know?
Call it the devil's Capri Sun.
Yeah.
We're innovating pissing right now.
We really are.
Well, yeah. No,
I get
tits
out my window,
full of piss, beds full of piss.
I get those
jugs
big jugs that Tom uses, like the big jugs of water with a little handle from the corner store. And it's one night I was just like, I wonder how much I actually have to pee every night, you know, because I get up and pee a lot when I'm like sleeping, but three, four, five times a night, filled up the whole jug.
God damn.
It's a lot of pee.
I feel like you're just bragging about how hydrated you are at all times. I'm so dehydrated, my pee smells in the morning. Like,
really?
Very strongly.
What does it smell like?
Well,
actually, let's save that
like
for the premium
like a,
content.
Like a very strong, like ammonia pee smell. And I looked it up because I was like, oh no, am I dying or have an STD or something?
Nicole's Google history, by the way, has got to be the best, like, you know, alt comedy Twitter feed. Why is my pee so stinky? 3:45
a.m. You're dehydrated, bitch, which I knew because it's like dark, dark, dark yellow.
I have to poop before I shower and after I shower and in the shower.
I like that you pee like a nice, like, Pilsner, you know? Like a,
yeah, I do. It's a dark stout.
A real dark, cold brew.
Seasonal piss.
Piss, yeah, yeah.
Hints of cranberry.
No, I need to drink more water for sure.
Yeah.
Why aren't you drinking enough water? It seems pretty intuitive.
I hate water. It doesn't taste good to me.
All right, well, have you tried not being 6 years old?
No.
Have you considered that a solution to this easy problem?
No,
wow, yeah. That
my
was
my entire life.
And appreciate the gravity of this. That was the one of the most infantile things ever said on the Mean Boys podcast.
Yeah. On a show where our last episode on Patreon is literally called Poop.
Well.
Yeah, I've been taking some pretty ridiculous antidepressant shit.
Oh, yeah, you want to show Nicole that dump?
Oh, should I show Nicole the picture?
Yeah.
You want to see a picture of the worst shit we've ever seen?
Absolutely.
I mean, this, and I'm like, and I'm going to.
This is your shit?
This is my shit. And this shit has different biomes like a Minecraft save. All right? There are so many different elements of this shit. Are you sure? First
come
of all.
On, just show it to me.
Whoa!
This is my new
that
favorite.
The most open I've ever seen your eyes.
Yeah, it's for real. This is my new favorite segment
that
on the show,
not,
by the way.
I was not expecting
now,
that.
Now,
that looks like a cow shit.
Let me give you a little tour here. Now, what is that blue cloud poking out from underneath the bottom of it? You see, I'm going to turn the brightness up.
Are you eating
It's
pets?
Blue. You see? No, I didn't eat any candy or anything funky.
Oh, my God.
There's a blue cloud.
That looks like it
now,
came from an animal.
Now, look at this log at the top underneath the cloud of the cloud that's obscuring all of Mordor right
I'm
here.
I'm so concerned for you.
So I had like a butt plug of regular shit, and then I uncorked a champagne bottle of doom, and the rest of this happened. And again, this is stuff we pointed out in the Patreon, but just so I can explain to Nicole again, the shit that is like, it's first of all, it's diarrhea that's popping out of the toilet bowl, which like, first of all, like the diarrhea crested the water. And the diarrhea that's on top over here is wetter than the poop that's in the toilet.
It looks like a hot spring. It probably smelled like one, too. The, like, really disgusting.
Oh, like the
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And see, this part is chunky, but this stuff over here is
Are
cloudy
you sure
and
there
smooth.
Isn't sulfur in there? Oh, my God. That's so disgusting, Connor.
I know.
That's the problem.
How much would it
cost? No, imagine how that felt inside of me all day.
How much would it cost?
I'm on antidepressants, and that's not a thing for me.
Which one are you on?
I'm also I drink a lot of energy drinks, which makes your shit pretty gross and liquidy, but I've never had that kind of shit. I'm on Prozac.
Okay. I don't know. It always gave me the fucking, it always gave me the mud butt.
How much would it cost to get you to text that to the most famous person in your phone?
Oh, I think John DiMaggio would appreciate it. He sent me a picture of him taking a shit when he did the podcast.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, that'd be blood for blood.
Yeah, yeah.
I think he'd be down for that. And also, is that really the most famous person in your phone?
I guess Andy Dick. I'll send it to Andy Dick
for
free.
Oh, you should
text it to Andy Dick right now.
I don't really have a lot of fame. I'm not a very good climber or networker. I'm trying to think of who the most famous person in my phone is.
Yeah, maybe Jeff.
I don't even know. I have Jeff's number. Okay. Yeah, Jeff.
Yeah.
You want to hear the saddest thing? You know who the most famous person in my phone probably is? Pauly Shore.
Oh, yeah. Will you text it to Pauly Shore?
Because he's more famous than Jeff, right?
You want to see if he wants to
lose
that juice?
Dude, I'm sure. I think Pauly Shore.
Speaking of juice, that's actually what the Lizzo song is about.
It doesn't not look like one of Lizzo's thighs.
Wow, that was...
Oh, what? It's chocolatey and glistening.
That was not nice.
Her thighs probably smell better. Like,
I'm glad that nobody can see that picture because, wow, Keith, I was...
I think they can extrapolate. There's no version of that poop that doesn't make that an insult.
I want this picture of this shit when the legend we're building around it to be the Mean Boys podcast unredacted Mueller report. Yeah. I want petitions. You know, I want a whole Discord team trying to hack my iCloud. Actually, don't do that.
I wonder if you posted that on Instagram, would
you
say
you're going
to be removed?
What?
Somebody hacking your iCloud?
No. I said don't do that.
Oh, okay.
But now it's too late. What are you going to say, Nicole?
I wonder if you posted that on Instagram if it would be removed.
Like,
I gotta figure
it counts as violence against the human eye. you know what I mean?
Yeah, but it's some manner of felony.
You can smell in the smell of that thing,
concern.
Guys.
It's a health post. Like,
so if you ask a legitimate medical question around it, would it be okay?
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to save it for Mental Health Awareness Day.
That shit is definitely some kind of medical marvel.
You know, and it's supposed to be a selfie of you looking cute and be like, I'm on meds and it's hard, but it's good because I'm still here. And I'm going to be like, I had to take a look at the shit I had to take.
Yeah, here's what fucking healing smells like.
Yeah, bitch. Look at me thrive.
Now I feel like you're just making fun of my Instagram.
Oh, I'm not. I don't begrudge you. I get it. I just, you know, it's fun that that's because that's my version of it.
Well, no one wants to watch a pretty boy uplift himself. You know what I mean? But if you just posted a picture of his weird antidepressant thump.
I feel
I would laugh, but this is the first time Keith's called me pretty in years.
I call you pretty every day.
I know. What are you going to say?
Never mind.
No, you can't never mind on this podcast.
Yeah. I was just going to say, I feel like you just described the Instagram of me and all your ex-girlfriends.
Oh, yeah. No, I like your Instagram.
I overcame everything. Mental illness, crippling depression, dating Connor.
Also, look how cute I am.
Oh, I know.
I'm a little hotter than I was crazy.
I've yet to overcome dating them. Oh, my God. I'm so out of the fucking game, dude. I'm just here's what I'm into, vaping, athleisure, piss jugs.
I don't want any of it. Okay.
These are my garlic and the holy water. All right.
You know the old Groucho Marx thing of like I wouldn't want to be part of any club that would have me as a member.
Yeah.
I can't imagine you wanting to date anybody who'd want to date you.
That's the thing. I date women that hate
me. I was the same way for a long time, and then I had to get over it because I was lonely.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I was like, well, I guess if they want to date me, that's fine.
I think at some point, the self-loathing hits critical mass, and it's just like, well, I guess I'll allow myself to
be loved. I do think I've been hating
myself
less lately.
That's awesome.
Wow. How'd you do that?
Stopped hanging out with us?
No. I did have I was listening to I Am Beautiful, the I Am Beautiful, the Christina Aguilera song.
I believe it's You Are Beautiful.
Whatever.
You narcissist.
What?
You are
Everything's
beautiful.
me.
Just Nicole is beautiful.
She's talking to me, so yeah.
I'm the only person on earth.
And like,
your eyes don't look that close.
I almost thought it would be a funny bit to post like a video of me just like singing that to myself in the mirror and being like, this is my ritual before I go and hang out with Keith and Connor. But I thought you guys would take it to be serious. And because sometimes
no
I feel like
serious.
I'll make a joke about you guys being mean or me being sad, and then you guys will apologize, and then it makes me feel like sadder.
I don't want to actually bum you out.
We're just weenies. We love you. We don't want to, you know, I don't ever really actually want to hurt anybody's feelings. Like, if I say something cruel about you, I'm like 98% of the time trying to make you happy.
I've had this happen a few times where I think we have the pit bull playing with a small child conundrum. We're just trying to have a good time, but we forget we are pit bulls.
But no, sure, I like it because I don't like when
we're a couple of young Bobby Slaytons over here.
Hey, it makes me feel it makes me feel better than people feeling sorry for me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I'd rather, like, especially when I'm going through, like, depression, I guess, is a little different. And you guys are really good with that, actually. But, like, I think when I'm, like, going through something like a breakup or, like, something like you guys making jokes about it makes me feel better than, like, feeling sorry.
Oh, I'm the same way. It's like, you know, I'd much rather like someone, you know, say something like callous and crass about something.
Yeah, like I'd rather you make fun of my ex than be like, oh, I'm sorry.
I'm kind of that way too. Like, yeah, the sooner I can, like, even if I'm still feeling shitty about a thing, I'm like, this is what you make me laugh about it. It's going to like speed the process of me being able to just accept it and move through it.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Go for it.
You
have a fun story. I have a sad story.
No,
so
I have a fun
go.
Bobby Slayton. So I tried to give him a tag. I don't think it didn't work. Or he tried it a few times. It didn't really work. But it's pretty good. It's a good Bobby Slayton joke.
Right.
Which is, you know, his wife passed away. And he was doing jokes about it. And he's like, you know, people always talk, you know, use that expression, your late wife, your late wife. I hate that. She's dead, not black. I'm like, that's some good old racist comedy.
That's solid. Wait, that's the tag you gave him?
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah, I don't think he does it, but he got a kick out of it. It was kind of fun.
That is good.
Yeah. I like when you get to write a, you know, whatever, something like that.
Yeah,
out there
I get that.
International waters. I've never hated myself more.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
But you're fucking killing it in life.
It's funny. You always think, like, you hear, like, oh, blah, 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 won't make you happy. And you go, no. And then I'm really like, wow, this is, what the fuck?
It is true. Blah, 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 won't make you happy.
It won't. Yeah.
But I feel like it's nicer to be unhappy and, like, have certain things than be unhappy and not have those things.
I disagree.
When things
were worse in my life, at least it had some kind of direction.
Because Keith always tells me if I get big fake tits, I'll just be sad with big fake tits, and I'm like, that's fine. I'd rather be sad with big tits than sad with small tits.
No, because then you're gonna be sad and no one's gonna feel bad for you because you have big tits.
They'll catch my tears. Before they fall to the floor.
What do you have your boyfriend's hair down there for?
What chapter of the philosophy textbook is this? The big tits, small tits, girl conundrum?
My tits will catch my tears. Did Chelsea Handler write that?
Your tits will catch your tears, is that?
Yeah, no, I fucking...
It's a song I'm writing.
There's like an old quote or whatever that's like, you know, whatever you already are dealing with, like money or success or whatever it is, will only amplify that. So if you're an unhappy person, it will make you unhappier and make you feel emptier and shittier versus if you are a well-adjusted person, it'll make you have more access to things that will make you happy and make you feel better.
Yeah, I mean, it's like...
It's not going to fix or destroy you. It just is another
At
thing.
Least when I was incredibly poor, I had to do things. So I, like, had to, like, get out of bed or pee in a toilet, you know what I mean?
Right.
And now it's just...
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can spend more money on vices.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really have one except sneakers, and even they've stopped bringing me joy a while ago.
Sneakers have stopped bringing you joy?
You truly have, yeah. Well, I just am too embedded. I believe more so got into sneakers because I'm addicted to things that make me feel bad, and I would feel very stupid and bad for wanting and owning them, and then I would get them, and I would just feel disgusted with myself, and I'd go, good, you're trash.
I mean,
with your dumb shoes.
As someone
tight.
As someone who ate a whole ice cream cake. a few weeks ago to make myself feel better. I gotta
get on your vices. Then I might be able to fill out a pair of jorts in time for July. You know what I'm saying?
If you let her get you to become a fat guy and you didn't let me do it for a decade, I'm gonna be so mad.
I think you'd be happier fat.
Honestly, the other thing is I don't want to pour more gasoline on that fire I showed you the picture of earlier.
That's true.
Those are the shits you're taking as the healthiest person in this house.
Yeah, I don't know if I need to give that any more ammunition. that cannon's fully loaded.
And Taco Bell's not going to quell that fucking revolution.
I went to the gym earlier and I ran a couple miles on the treadmill and then I was like, oh, I got to take a shit. And then I went and about 20 minutes later, I just left the gym. I was just like,
I can't be here no more.
I can't, because it was like, oh yeah, there's more, and I don't know when. I'm literally at like fucking, just like, you know, in like you first have a baby.
Right.
It's like the baby is my own asshole. It's, you got to be on top of it all night. Yeah, it just never, and I'll get like just like all of a sudden it's happening. You know what I mean? And I gotta like do the fucking butt clench like fucking you know cowboy walk to the bathroom. Yeah.
I almost shit my pants during a meeting at work the other day.
Oh yeah,
and it was the worst because it was like. Generally, you can get up and go to the bathroom if you need to. Like, it's a pretty loose scenario.
Mm-hmm.
This is a moment where I could not get up and leave, but I was also, like, straight up turtle heading.
Oh,
shit. I miscalculated a fart, so I'm like, all right, I got to be cool and not shit my pants in front of a lot of people who can fire me.
Oh, man. Yeah, I mean, and honestly, I'm beginning to wonder if these antidepressants are the right move, because it's taken away one of the few things that brought me joy in life, which is farting.
Yeah.
You know, no longer can I fart with impunity. You know,
it's brought consequences.
Every
to your
shit
trumpet.
Your pants story starts with, I thought it was going to be a fart.
Every fart has become an important decision. You understand? Every single fart is a life or death game time call.
Yeah. You think it's a quick one. You're like, oh, no, there's an elbow on that motherfucker.
And then it's like, well, you know, Connor, stop eating only Mexican food and vegetable drinks. Well, I can't do that, you know, so I'm just, ugh.
Maybe not wear such light color breathable pants.
Oh my! If I shit my pants in my tracksuit, it would be devastating.
It'd be the most noticeable shit.
It really would.
Ever.
You would be able to see it from the front. Pretty immediately.
Look, you shit out your dick.
Look like a tampon fell through.
Yeah. I mean, there would be no playing this off.
Yeah.
What's the best kind of pants to shit? Maybe jorts. You know, because you can
bundle. No, because then it's going to come out.
It's going to come out the sides. That's true.
Jorts don't like have any. Yeah, breathe. It's just smearing around.
Maybe
well, you
like
want it contained,
black,
so you can ditch
yeah,
the pants.
Yeah, you would definitely want it contained.
I guess it's probably just a pair of skinny jeans.
Yeah, black skinny jeans.
See, I almost think it's you want like a dark cargo pant.
Why? So you've got extra pockets to hold your shit.
I guess. Well, you don't see any bulge from it if it's a bulger.
Oh yeah, but then it'll trickle down the legs, and then you got it in your shoes.
That's a fair point.
You know? Mm. And that's probably, I got to fit, like, that's the, you can change your pants, you know what I mean, or whatever, but it's like, you know, I guess.
We're talking like an accidental squirt or like a full shit.
Like, you know, you the hole is breached and some, you know, whatever, like.
Just start wearing
one
pull-ups.
Eighth of that picture I showed you gets out. Okay. I should start wearing what?
Pull-ups.
Pull-ups?
Yeah.
Oh, like diapers?
Yeah. You already look like the little kid who's like, I'm a big boy now.
That's going to fix my self-worth issues. Wearing a diaper.
I mean,
this is
self-care, Connor.
This is how I boss up my life.
It's not much different than piss jugs,
to
be honest.
If you shit your pants with the shit you showed us, it's beyond changing your pants. You're going to burn your house down at that point.
I'm going to have to get a different body.
You got to go to the Breaking Bad guy who fucking fakes your death and changes your identity.
Hi, one.
Like managing a Cinnabon fuckface.
One skin graft, please.
Turn me Chinese.
I know. And then the shower, it's like, I wouldn't even want to do that to a shower. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's enough poop to clog the drain. I guess you'd want to wipe it down.
For some reason, I think if Keith shit his pants during a meeting, it would be bad. But if you did, I think it would just make you more likable.
Interesting.
Because I think you're just very pretty and funny and whatever. And so people are just kind of like, probably like, fuck this guy. But if you shit your pants, they'd be like, oh, he's just like us.
Oh, that guy with acne scars on his face is smelly today.
Where?
Oh, I got right there from the...
God, a woman.
My second flesh-eating disease.
Yeah, I don't know if you heard about this. Connor got face rot in Florida.
I
oh,
did.
Did you really?
Yeah, yeah.
What did you sleep on?
A fan of this show's couch.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it's okay. I got to see some pretty cool D&D miniatures.
At what cost?
Yeah, that's what I think. I don't know where I got it specifically, but yeah, I had some amazing fucking shit going on my face. It was like...
Yeah, it looks okay now, but it was bad.
Yeah, I've been putting lotion on it, trying to make it go away, but I think I'm probably going to have 3 like permanent dents. I'm considering going to the dermatologist, but I don't know like what they can... If they can even do anything, or if they tell me to get... I might... Maybe it's like a plastic surgery scenario, and I'm like, I can't have that option because I might take it. You know what I mean?
I don't think there's anything wrong with seeing, though.
What,
like with, talking to them and just seeing what they think.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. Who cares? I've never really gotten by on my looks. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm not really like, even if I'm not like ugly, I'm not like someone you think of. My personality is enough to make me, you don't think of me as a hot guy at all, you know?
You've really rounded yourself down to a 6.5.
I think the thirst traps on Instagram begged you different.
No one thinks like, oh, that cute guy. They think like, oh, yeah, he yelled at me one time at Flappers.
Here's the thing. I think they think that cute guy, and then they speak to you for any extended period of time.
That's what I'm saying.
And then they're like, that mean guy.
Yeah, you know, the guy with the... With those weird brown and yellow pants with the terrible attitude. What's new in your life, Nicole?
Oh, you know.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Just doing nothing. I got back into therapy.
Oh, yeah?
So that's good.
Guy or girl?
A woman.
You got to go, girl. Guy therapist. I feel like that's... I feel like you knocked $150 an hour off your rate.
I can't,
you know?
Do guy therapy. I had one guy therapist when I was at UCLA.
I feel like it's just gonna be like, well, why don't you stop being a bitch? You know, you ever think about it that way?
Tried fake tits.
He was very about like tough love. Honestly, the one thing that I liked that he did was like, if I would say something, he'd turn it around and repeat it back to me in a way that sounded ridiculous, so that I was like, oh yeah, that does...
That's the thing therapists do in general.
That
does, though, right?
Make no sense. Yeah, but like in a very blunt way. Like I kind of used to think like I had to like be alone in my depression because no one would understand.
Oh, here I find out I've not been being an asshole. I've been doing vigilante therapy my whole life.
I was going to say it would be like if Connor was my therapist.
I'm like the fucking Batman for your emotions over here,
kids. And he's like, well, why don't you reach out to your friends? And I'm like, well, I don't know if they would like understand. I don't want to push them away and make them deal with my shit. And he was like, yeah, you're right. Your friends are dumb and wouldn't understand, and they're fucking assholes who would walk away from you when you're... And I was like, I didn't say that. And he was like, yes, you did. And I was like, okay.
Well, you know, he's like, oh, I listen to their podcast, and that's my professional opinion.
Then he leaves a voicemail. Hey there, mean boys. All glory to the fudge lord. I got this sad bitch I work for.
But the problem is, because of my inherent need for men to like me, I
thought you were gonna say for my inherent need to ferment, and I was like, no. What dear, like, pray tell, are you fermenting?
For men to think I'm like
as a
cool
cabbage
chick,
pushed last.
I wouldn't be super open and vulnerable with him because he was a dude, and I just didn't feel comfortable,
right,
like being vulnerable. And also, he was also young. He wasn't even, because it was at UCLA, and so he was just in his fifth year of school.
Oh,
like
shit.
He was like about to be a therapist, so he was just like this young like dude, and I was like, this can't be my therapist.
Yeah.
Like, you, I could fuck you, like, if I wanted to, I could fuck you, and that should not be a thing with your therapist.
I can't like have a therapist.
I love the idea of you and your therapist both thinking that same thing. If I wanted to, I could fuck you.
Can't have a therapist that played the same Pokemon I did, you know? That doesn't sit right with me.
I've been playing Pokemon recently.
Pokemon
too.
Go?
No, just the Game
Pokemon
Boy
Pokemon Stay.
Yeah, okay. On DS. Because I used to play it as a child, and so I've been playing it recently just because I was like, well, I miss playing it. My boyfriend plays it, and I always make fun of him for playing it, but then secretly miss playing it as a child. So I was like, can I play? And he was like, yeah. So I've been playing it a lot, like an embarrassing amount. Yeah.
You know, I am starting to want a dude therapist just for certain issues. You know, just because it's hard to say to a woman, and it's like, now why can I come if I just met her, but not if I'm in love with her? You know, but what is that all about? That's a weird one to drop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like guy questions.
But I think women get it too. Like,
I'm sure, yeah. But it does feel it's rough. You know, I'm like, well, you want to? For instance, if I wanted to show a picture of that poop, you know, I would like a guy to.
You shouldn't be showing any.
Do you think you have a little bit of like Madonna whore complex?
The only person who shows a psychologist their poop like that is like the guy next to Hannibal Lecter in The Silence of the Lambs.
I will say my, maybe this is too, whatever. No, I don't care. I'm going to say it anyway. One day I was really drunk, and I like told my boyfriend, I was like, you can do anything you want, like anything. And he was like, okay. So he face fucked me. And then like the next day he was like, I feel really bad for doing that. And I was like, why? And he was like, because you're like my sweet little angel. And that's not what you do to a sweet little angel. You do that to like a, like, and I was like, no, you can fuck me like a whore sometimes. It's fine. And I feel like guys have that in my their head to where like if they're in love with someone, they can't like do fucked up shit.
I don't fuck anyone like a whore.
You should try.
I'll freak people out by being very affectionate, and they're like, "Whoa, fuck, we're in Tucson." You know what I mean?
But like, once you're in love, it's harder for you to come.
Yeah, I don't know. I just can't. I can't come from having sex in general. I think I've cummed from having sex probably less than 10 times in my entire life.
But like jacking off, you can.
Oh yeah, I'm undefeated. Mm. No, I have tapped out
like
a few times.
You pull out and crank at the end, and like shoot on the back.
I see that it's awkward to me. I don't like doing it. I'd rather
Why?
Just
That's
not.
That's called
cum.
Pulling out. That's what everyone does.
Yeah.
Well, I know, but it's like I don't like just jacking off on someone. Like I've done it. Like women have asked me to do it, and it's like, ugh, it's just very like it's not satisfying. A and B, it just feels very violent, you know. And I don't really like the way doing it makes me feel. I've even had a girl like tell me like face fuck me, and I'm like, oh fuck, do I have to? That's horrifying to just like. I'm like, that's where you breathe with that. That's I don't
do
need
enjoy
to
enjoy having sex.
I don't think so. Not really.
You don't enjoy honestly, not having sex either.
I mean, I like being funny. I like being
you
funny
like
while
having
I'm naked.
A girl sit on your face.
That I do like.
That's like
but that's more of a sensory deprivation tank.
That's
thing.
Like a female version of face fucking.
Yeah.
Exactly yeah.
What it is.
Yeah. That's
you breathe
good.
With yours.
No. Yeah. But that just. Yeah, you know, sex is just like, I guess I probably more so just think like, well, I should be trying to do this so I can be cool for my neighbors when I'm 12. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And ultimately, it's just kind of a drag.
I get that.
That's why I'm living the joke life, guys.
Man, I can't wait till you find like the perfect person for you, and I can't wait to see what that person is like.
Oh.
It's going to happen. And I want to know this person.
Pool's closed, ladies. Yeah, you had 26 years. Yes, I'm including
retiring.
Ages 1 to
yeah.
14.
Could have swooped in when Danny was 3, but nah.
One got through.
Yeah. That's the equivalent of the guy who pooped in the pool and ruined the swimming for everybody else.
Oh, yeah. What is molestation if not pooping in the pool of your brain?
Your sexual development.
Yeah. Pooping in my formative years. I'm still finding chunks to this day. I bet the YMCA guy, I bet there has been like a puke or a shit where he's like, just when I think I got it all. Underneath the drain at the bottom? How?
Yeah. How are we finding new pockets?
That's cool. How much is your therapist? Is there on like insurance?
Well, so what happened
was, or did you go to that like where the Arkham Asylum villains go?
It's the same therapist I was going to before, and like I lost my insurance recently because I turned 26 and I do not have a job. So I went off my medication and wasn't in therapy and was falling into a deep, 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 deep depression. And then
no, that's like my favorite Fear song. Deep, 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 deep depression.
And then I had to have a relationship conversation where it was like, if you don't take care of yourself, this is you need to take care of yourself, basically. And so I was like, you're right.
If you don't go back on your meds, you're no more face fucking for you, Missy. You're not getting your face fucked until you start.
Here's the thing, like.
You got to fuck your own face first.
I think that's maybe the good part about being in a relationship is it really holds a mirror up to your face. And like, because I would keep going.
And then Zach shattered.
I would keep going and being depressed until it got to like a terrible point. But because there is someone else that is affecting, you know, it made me face it sooner.
Right.
So I texted my therapist and I was like, is there anything we can work out? And so she's working on like a sliding scale for me and charging me less.
No, that's cool.
Than
that's,
she would.
That's really nice of her.
Yeah.
See, that's the part that I hate is I hate someone, my emotions affecting other people. You know what I mean? I find it very annoying.
It's I mean, honestly, it is good for you, I think, in some ways to have that mirror being held up to you.
Yeah, because, I mean, nobody exists in a vacuum. Like.
Yeah, because if I... Exactly, because even if it's not affecting, like, your girlfriend or boyfriend...
Hold on, I have an idea I have to write down. Turd vacuum to go with piss jug. You guys, this has been a really productive conversation for me. I think this is going to set me on the right track.
Yeah, we're all still very sad, but we've solved a lot of waste disposal.
No, if I got like a shop vac, you know what I mean?
Yeah, a plop vac.
I may only have to leave this bed for work and, you know, family events.
I know you want me to be excited for you, but you're just building like Jetsons technology to enable your shitty depression.
No, yeah, it would be, I could get like a funnel, you know, for
meets the sad Jetson.
I would have different
hates his life.
I would have different attachments for different kinds of dumps. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Gun prices.
How do you know what kind of dump it's?
I'm gonna start depressed guy sharper image where I sell gadgets and gizmos, you know, that help you complacify your life. You know what I'm saying? Go. All right, so there's one that's got like a funnel on top. That's for the messy days, you know, when you're worried about a little squirt back, you know, and it's got the, you know, those little brushes that they have to massage some of the fine dirt and the particulate out of. They're still there, but they're for wiping.
Okay.
You know? And then
I think you need like a mounted on the wall, like a gerbil's water bottle, so you can just kind of like.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Get yourself. Maybe have one for like food too. Just some sort of tasteless slurry.
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
I,
what's a, there's
one is
to be
one
an
is water, one is iced coffee, and then one is NyQuil.
To your bed.
The three main liquids.
The amount of technology we're buying, it would genuinely be cheaper to kill yourself.
Oh, and that's what you'll be doing in the long run. Yeah.
When I'm really depressed, I do take NyQuil just to sleep.
Oh, I would love to be a farm animal. Going in the little Temple Grandin a cow box that squeezes you.
What's the opposite of cage-free? Make me one of those.
Oh, yeah, dude, that'd be nice, you know?
Sorry, I didn't mean to step over what you said.
Were you going to say something?
I don't remember.
You have any ideas for my catalog?
I'm thinking about it. I when I'm depressed, I want like Jack in the Box tacos delivered directly to my bed.
So you have a thing
for
that.
Yeah, it's called Postmates.
Yeah. Well, then I have to get up and go to the door, and I also have to see a person. I have to be able to be pantsless.
I mean, you could put up one of those Craigslist ads where it's just like, I'm laying down in my bed. Here's my address. The door is unlocked. Someone come over and bring me Jack in the Box, and you can face fuck me.
Bare bottom pig / pretty hungry.
I'm just gonna start writing clickbait life hack articles that are completely not worth it, like how to get free food delivered to your door.
And it's just like yourself every, gang railed by a Craigslist.
Works every time, and then there's gonna be 6 pages of like ads where it's like, you might think that this won't work, click, but it does, click.
Was that with
forhims.com? Click. This technique, click. Roman.com, click.
Was I with you when we posted the Will Fuck for Food ad on Craigslist?
No, I think this was one of your private adventures.
It was me and Elise that did this. It was just, we would just post like fake Craigslist sex accounts, and one of them was genuinely, if you bring me a bag of wiener schnitzel, I'll let you fuck me in the ass. Uh-huh. And then we would just read through people's like things, and they're like, literally, I'm 2 blocks from a wiener schnitzel right now. I'll bring it over on my bike.
Well, if you're riding the bike.
One guy literally said, I got...
You're riding the bike, you're staying out of my ass. I'll tell you that.
One guy said, I got poppers and pretzel buns. I was like, man, we should probably fuck this guy.
I got poppers and pretzel buns aplenty.
All right, well, that was a rollicking start to the show. The Mean Boys Podcast will be right back right after this.
Welcome back to our live coverage of this year's first annual Straight Pride Parade in Boston, Massachusetts. I'm Rick Dumpler.
And I'm Shannon Chang Meyerowitz, and we're here in the Channel 5 news booth overlooking the parade route. And so far today, we've seen a procession of the best and straightest this city has to offer.
That's right, Shannon. There was that unforgettable Buffalo Wild Wings float, the spellbinding Wingstop float, surprisingly no Chick-fil-A float, though.
Rick, the CEO of Chick-fil-A, said in a statement that he was concerned that the Straight Pride Parade was, quote, a trap. And that, quote, I bet we're going to show up and there's going to be anybody there except for a bunch of chicks with Skrillex haircuts throwing milkshakes at us.
A fair concern, but they are sorely missed today.
And right now we're watching the world's largest marching band without any flute players.
While they're tromboning the shit out of everybody, we should talk about the fact that Grindr is reporting record usage in the 1 mile radius of the parade route.
That's right, Rick. And users of the popular gay app will note that it is a veritable cornucopia of headless torsos, like a Greek statue garden with a farmer's tan.
They're here, they're queer, and they're on the DL looking for anonymous action. So if you're a local business owner with a public restroom, now would be a great time to make sure you also have a mop.
Oh, look, the Grand Marshal is making his entrance.
That's right, Shannon. For the first year of the Straight Pride Parade, the search for a Grand Marshal was a top priority. Initial choices included Joe Rogan, Adam Carolla, and trying Joe Rogan one more time just in case he missed the first text.
But in the end, the selection committee settled on a grand marshal that encapsulates all the proud traditions and values of the heterosexual male community. This year's parade is being led by some guy named Ken, who's wearing sweatpants in a sit-down restaurant.
Look at him, Shannon. The sheer disrespect for any semblance of class or culture as he spits his gum into a cloth napkin and orders a well-done steak to go with his ketchup.
You have to respect the craftsmanship that goes into his ability to ignore his wife while he scrolls through the pages of Instagram models at the dinner table and comments, "Gorgeous," on whichever one shows the most tit.
And a true rainbow of stains on those sweatpants, Shannon. I mean, blue? What could he possibly have eaten that was blue? It truly boggles the mind. I mean, is there anything this fat fuck wouldn't eat?
Pussy. Because he thinks it makes him gay. Fun trivia fact, that bit of mental gymnastics is the closest he's come to exercise since 2007.
And he's tipping 0% while citing a Ben Shapiro interview he didn't even fully understand, which means it's time to go to commercial, but stick around because we'll be right back with the parade's final float, a salute to tucked-in t-shirts. Live from the Straight Pride Parade, I'm Rick Dumpler.
And I'm wine drunk at 2 in the afternoon and desperately unhappy.
The Straight Pride Parade is brought to you by Willful Ignorance, Thinly Veiled White Supremacist Rhetoric, and Subway. Subway. They've never said they hate gay people, but it feels like something they do, doesn't it?
And the Mean Boys podcast returns. I do love doing the show with Nicole and Connor because I get to watch them just watching, like, stare into two different middle distances. When nothing's happening.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the three of us, we're all looking different. It looks like...
into the
like,
void of our souls.
Or, like, yeah. One of those, like, pictures where they, like, superimpose you looking one way in front of you looking the other way. You know, like a bad old, like, Sears photo.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of fun. But we're back to do the one segment we still like doing, the Mexican Joke-Off.
Ay, so topical.
Woo! Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun.
There you go. You got it. Yeah. I'll take it away this week. Whatever we're doing.
It's the freaking weekend, baby. Time to tell me some jokes.
Charmin created a roll of toilet paper that will last for 3 months. Big deal. I've been using the same t-shirt for 6 years.
Damn. Sounds like someone's going to be a customer of my new catalog.
Yeah. The dumper image.
Yeah. Reusable, like, wipes, you know? Yeah. So the t-shirt from the, you know... You're at the coding camp your mom made you go to try to get you to get a real job, but you left because of your anxiety.
It's a perfect system to just reinvest the money you don't feel you deserve back into creating a negative environment for yourself.
I think it's good. Okay, guys.
Be the rat that buys his own cage.
Yeah. A pride of 14 lions have escaped from a South African national park. Finally, a pride parade I can get behind. That was for the straight guys, you know? Yeah. It's got cool, angry animals.
Tough straight boys.
Yeah, cool. Killing stuff.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Yeah, murder.
I have a pride parade joke, too.
Do it.
Boston is having a straight pride parade. Homophobes are having a parade, confirming their worst fear. Perhaps they can be tricked into being gay.
They got hornswoggled.
I know, yeah. I mean, I don't see... What is accomplished with a parade? You know, what work is being done?
Just being gay? That's...
Not the Pride Parade. I get like a celebration, but like the New Year's Day parade where it's look at we made.
I have
something.
Always hated parades.
Yeah.
I think they're so pointless and dumb.
Yeah.
You know I'm going to say what I'm going to say, and I'm going to be lambasted for it. I like parades.
Of course you do.
It's a lot of people in one place enjoying the same thing. There's a lot of costumes. I like it.
Yeah.
I want to apologize for that.
That's your choice.
Yeah.
Your choice is to like parades.
I was born a parade fan.
We'll see what Mr. Tesla Coil has to say about that.
Bystanders claim they saw a baby shark on a subway train in New York City. Said animal control, for the last time, you're not allowed to call Puerto Rican kids that anymore.
I was expecting for sure a baby shark joke.
No, baby shark.
Someone at work fucking showed me that song, and God, am I mad at them. Because that's not one of those things you can hear and forget.
Wasn't that from like a long time ago?
That's living rent-free
up
here.
I'd
avoided it for like 4 years, you know? I was one of those guys who escaped from prison. I had a job with a different name at a Jiffy Lube in another state, and I thought I was just like, I'm going to ride it out, live a simple life, and
the
then
life
fuck.
Came looking for you.
It came back to haunt me.
I love that something that vicious also can be a baby.
Well, most things are babies.
I know, but doesn't it make the world seem like a happier place?
Wait, this is it.
Like, if you think of like the scariest, most racist, homophobic guy. Like at one point he was a cute little baby.
Yeah.
That's
for, I get that.
And you're saying sharks hate gay people? Is where you're getting at? I think. Michigan Hotel is offering free lodging for anyone traveling to get an abortion. Due to a massive influx of phone calls, they've added the room's bathtub size to the frequently asked questions page on their website.
Dude, I saw this hotel and like. I like what they're doing. Like, they're basically treating the abortion clinic like Disneyland, where you get a free shuttle bus there. They're really building their whole experience around it. Can you imagine a sadder place in the world than the Continental Breakfast at the abortion hotel?
Oh, my God. That's great. Yeah,
just
yeah.
A woman with just, like, she's been crying for 18 hours just trying to work the waffle maker.
No, she's like, no, batter's how we got into this mess in the first place.
I guess I got room for the whipped cream now.
I think that's lovely.
Yeah.
Abortions should be a
resort style experience. Yeah.
Yeah, you should get like a massage after and
Empty by Sandals.
When it comes out, you should get your picture taken like Splash Mountain. And you could buy it for $35 at the and you get to see all the other ones and
swim with the unborn fetuses.
Wow. Like the dolphin pool, but it's little chunks falling through.
Swim in the gene pool.
Looks like David Cronenberg made a bowl of cereal.
Yeah, they are not really tickling me like the dolphins did.
Yeah.
A woman on Pakistan Airlines opened the emergency exit, thinking it led to a toilet. They were in Pakistan, so she wasn't wrong.
That's actually really good.
Wow. Everywhere is a
Did
toilet.
She die?
I had to read the article because I was like, how is that possible? Like the air pressure, but the plane was still on the ground.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was just mid-air.
Yeah, she's just like, whoops, and then nobody, falls out of the plane.
She thought it was the most intense bathroom lock of all time, and everyone's like, well, she'll figure it out.
She like pulled the whole bar down. Well, I guess they really need to lock up these toilets.
Speaking of planes, a Spirit Airlines passenger was banned for life for vaping on a plane. In related news, Connor McSpadden has canceled the remainder of his gigs for 2019.
Yeah. Wow,
I almost wrote that same joke.
I know you did.
You guys, it's not that hard to vape on the airplane.
I know. I've vaped on a plane before.
I do it the entire time I'm on the plane in front of everybody. It's great.
By the way,
vaping, piss jugs, athleisure.
Back to that. And
that's my gym tan laundry.
This is the Justice League of bad things white guys do.
I know, and I'm being true to myself, and I'm accepting that I love all of them.
There you go.
Yeah.
I do think that based on the shits Connor are taking, you guys should have an emergency door exit style lock on your bathroom.
Like it has to be hermetically sealed.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like E.T.'s coming over.
Yeah.
You have to be de-loused after you take a shit in there.
I did take a shower after the one I texted you guys.
I would hope so.
Yeah.
More for the emotional.
It was like a rape shower. Yeah. You were violated by your own body, sure.
That shit just kind of happened to me.
Yeah.
Gaspar Noé presents Everybody Poops.
It was just, I was sitting right here, and then all of a sudden, my whole life changed, is what happened with that shit.
Hashtag me number two.
Hey, a motor. That's pretty damn good.
That's solid work. Unlike his shit.
No, there's a solid one underneath the diarrhea.
Well, like, hopefully you're talking about your next joke.
like I said, it was like, you know, someone put a shrimp in the cocktail glass of that dump. You know what I mean? It was garnished.
Yeah, the celery stock that is
like
the
one
log.
Of those trashy New Orleans party for the whole table drinks that comes with chicken fingers sticking out
that
of it.
Shit, you know, came in a fishbowl.
No, it really, yeah,
it was sparklers.
And I should have done it in a coconut, you know. I'm going to start keeping coconuts on hand.
There you go. Yeah. Dumb nuts.
All right, guys. A motorcycle died on the I-95 freeway in Florida. Witnesses say he got really small and then all his friends drove right past him laughing. He then muttered something about getting the, quote, bad controller and killed himself. Yeah, he got struck by lightning and just, like, exploded and died.
Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ.
It wasn't great.
That's fucking gnarly.
Yeah, it sucks.
That's also the most metal way you could die.
Yeah, that is true.
I mean, I guess, like, you know, if you're going to go, I mean, you're not going to see it coming. You know, wide open freeway, just kapow, you're done. I mean, that's not bad.
Planning the funeral for that guy is somebody having to teach someone how to play a Molly Hatchet song on the bagpipes.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Police thank a quote-unquote helpful drug dealer for leaving a stash alongside a name and an address. If being retarded is considered helpful, I'm goddamn Mother Teresa.
So you're very retarded? Yeah. What a weird self-burn.
Well, look, I was going to go for Tom, but he's not here. Yeah. So I was like, I'll just turn this on myself.
That one doesn't work because of how much we care about you. Do you see that?
Fucking gay retard.
It's love in action.
I just want to be self-deprecating. Why can't you let me?
Speaking of self-defecating, advance. When are we going to have the tubes?
I do a lot of self-defecating humor.
You guys ready to hear a really bad joke?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
A man stole thousands of dollars from a bank armed with nothing but an avocado. Guacamole robbery. Where was this bank? A Chipotle?
Shut up.
A Chipotle?
Damn, what did he do? What kind of?
He had an avocado and he's like, I'm robbing this bank. I think he pretended it was a grenade or something.
What kind of Tim Roth fucking Pulp Fiction plan is that?
It worked.
I guess a grenade. I mean, I'll give you that.
Yeah.
This guy, I think if you do that, you should get to keep the money.
Yeah, it's like the fucking balls it took.
Oh, yeah. This there is a magic strawberry. Yeah. All right. The World Health Organization has officially recognized workplace burnout as a legitimate medical phenomenon. They said they did this to stop a worldwide Mondays epidemic. Yeah, there we go. Really
needs extra guac.
If really you don't just, give me your money,
really
you're,
just dilberting my ass over the
toast.
Finish line over here. That's pretty good.
I just went back to riffing on Keith's
pretty
joke
good, pretty
because
good
I didn't
the
know what
avocado
to say
robbery
about
stuff.
Oh man. Okay.
The only injury was when he accidentally stabbed himself in the hand.
Connor, Woody Allen, avocado bank robber. Go.
No, I can't right now.
Okay. Women of color called out dictionary.com's offensive definition of black. It defines black as lacking brightness and hue, and synonyms include gloomy and evil. To be fair, if you're outraged by dictionary.com, you're probably kind of a bummer.
Fair point.
Oh, yeah. We are really getting down to the sawdust of outrage,
see,
aren't we?
I do think
seems like it was a white guy who did that and he blackfished him.
Yeah, I think it's... I do think, yeah, like, what the fuck? They're defining the color black as in, like, your t-shirt black.
Yeah.
Not, like, people black.
Yeah, I mean, I guess evil is a weird one.
Well, because if you say, like, black humor, that's, like, evil.
What also
humor.
Went on to other synonyms include poor, late.
Well, I mean, I guess, like...
Bad at voting.
Yeah, I guess there is some inherent racism in saying, like, oh, you have a black heart. But, again, saying you have a white heart just means it's full of the Mountain Dew residue. You know? It's, like, it's not really... I'm not like, ooh, a strong Caucasian heart.
Yeah.
You don't hear about a lot of those.
A white heart is filled with nacho cheese and chemical depression. Like, that's what a white heart is. Mm-hmm. All right. I got one more in here. What's the good one? There's no good one. Well, here's the least bad one. A kitten was stoned to death this week. Authorities are blaming the attack on the world's leading anti-cat terror group, MISIS. It's like ISIS, but they're mice.
I thought you said it was a bad one.
They don't like cats at all.
No, that wasn't funny enough for how sad it made me.
Oh, about the cat getting stoned to death?
Stone a kitten.
Well, I don't know. Maybe it was gay. You ever think about that?
It was a girl cat and it tried to drive.
Yeah, what if that cat... No,
that's even more adorable.
Yeah.
Cats can't drive.
It thinks it's people. No, it's a woman.
That's so funny. America's Funniest Home Videos in the Islamic State. It's just like, look at this woman. She thinks she is people.
Oh, my God. That's
my
so
name is
funny.
Tom Bragaga. This week's challenge.
That's so funny.
Send us your home movies of you cutting off the heads of a journalist.
Funny things you do.
Woman,
stabbing all
people.
The Jew, Algeria, or wherever. This is not Jew.
Algeria? That's Al Jazeera is the channel.
Yeah, I fucked. Algeria was the wrong poll, but.
Algeria is.
Look, I was riffing a racist parody of the America's Funniest Home Videos theme song. I didn't fact check it.
Oh, I forgot that. It has a theme song?
Oh, yeah.
My family watched AFV every Sunday for decades.
I don't think the Tom Bergeron reboot had it, but the original Saget home videos had like
This girl I was kind of dating, it was funny, she did nail me because she was like, you really are just like an edgy Tom Bergeron is your style of humor. you like offensive Tom Bergeron jokes. And I was like, yep, that's pretty much.
Yeah, that God, she fucking puts you on a cross, dude. That's brutal.
Wow, dude, you figured it out.
Yeah.
My whole thing.
Done got nailed.
All right, guys. A missing Texas hiker was found alive after being missing for over a week. When rescued, authorities told him, oh, shit, you're the guy that won that taco eating contest.
We missed Tom.
Yep, Tom is where? What state is he in? He's at a wedding.
I don't, a state of disarray would be my guess.
Yeah, I mean, I
imagine he has one shoe on his head, one in a tree.
What's funny, when Tom goes out of town, I don't know, Tom and I don't text much, but I just get these kind of like non sequiturs about like his, via Twitter of what is going on. And I saw one the other day where I'm like, oh, this is not going great. Got to smoke a cigar with my dad last night for the first time since I was 8. That's, and again, every statement is has within it thousands of questions.
Tom is like Batman in that, like, you never know when he's going to show up, but he sometimes shows up when you need him to.
Yep.
But a lot of times you just end up getting mugged in an alley.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've been having this fantasy where I am just sitting smoking a cigar in a top hat lately, and I just, I don't
you
know
just
why.
Do that.
I want to do that.
You go to Party City. This is, yeah. This is a $3 fantasy.
It just feels right. You
Man,
know?
Right. I miss unemployed thoughts. They're great. Where you're just like, I should get a tracksuit, you know?
2020 Democrats are calling for the end of the ban on gay men donating blood, focusing more on banning people who have multiple sexual partners without protection. So you can donate blood if you're a gay guy, unless you're a gay guy.
That rocks.
Wow. Yeah, I do remember when I donated blood in community college, they make you fill out this form. It's like, you know, have you traveled outside the country in the last year? And I was like, no. It's like, have you had unprotected sex in the last year? I was like, no. Have you used any intravenous drugs in the last year? No. How about any regular drugs? No. Have you had multiple sexual partners in the last 3 months? No. And I'm like, I get it. I suck. Like, I'm lame. I understand. It was just a whole
thing.
Can you
even ride a bike?
It was just the whole form could just be like, are you a fucking nerd? Well, then fucking squeeze this rubber ball and pony up, Sally.
Yeah, I think it's ironic that, like, you can't, the only restriction, or the restriction is that you can't donate blood unless you're 16, like you have to be 16, but I feel like under 16 is the only time you're not doing any of that shit.
Right.
Well, it's also,
we should drain blood from children.
Yes.
What about those of
get
us
on
who
board.
Want,
I mean, they're the ones getting shot, so
yeah.
I feel like it's,
I want
know,
some,
it's,
I also want some fresh, vigorous blood.
Yeah,
I don't
fresh,
want some old
blood.
Ass dudes, shitty, dusty ass, but his blood smells like a garage full of spider webs
children's
and shit.
Blood
when I was a kid,
is the
I
future.
Love Nickelodeon, because they're sort of marketing hook. Was it's made by kids for kids? I want that, but for hospitals now.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Just when you get shot at a school, you go to like the Nick Studios version of a hospital.
I'm just saying, if you got a blood transfusion from a 56-year-old guy that just goes every week because it's a nice thing to do, you do not feel nearly as good as when you're fucking riding like a 7-year-old transfusion straight from the tap. You know what I mean? You got all this energy. You're all excited about shit.
This patient needs 2 pints of A-positive and a pizza lunchable. Stat.
Yeah. Why are we not taking blood from children?
Why do I have a craving? You know, when you get an organ transplant, why do I have a craving for Cinnamon Toast Crunch for the first time in
why do
decades?
I feel like I could roller.
Blade. So many Fruit Loops lately.
Yeah,
I forgot how much I loved cereal, and then I did hear like someone mention Cinnamon Toast Crunch like last week, and I was like, "Why have I not been eating cereal lately?" And so I just went to the store and I got myself some Fruit Loops.
If you eat too many Fruit Loops, you can't donate blood.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Because you're gay.
Talking about gay buttholes.
Yeah.
Anyway, your cereal story. You've just been cerealing out.
It's not much of a story as much as it is just me.
It's frankly barely a statement.
This is just,
it's more an acknowledgement of a product currently available.
This show is now just the view for people that are about to kill themselves.
You ever just want to sit around, smoke a cigar in a top hat, and eat Fruit Loops?
Welcome back to the view of the abyss.
Yeah. The view of the edge of the tallest building that's unlocked. All right, guys. That was the Mexican joke off. You're all caught up on the news. We'll be right back right after this. Hey, mean boys and girls. Today's show is brought to you by Himalaya, a brand new podcasting app.
Ooh, that sounds great. Tell me about it.
awesome start. Can't wait for the next episode to drop. Well, be one of the first to listen to Mean Boys a day early, only on Himalaya. Himalaya is a brand new podcast. I covered some of this earlier. Where you can find every single podcast you love and some future faves. Oh, fuck. I don't even kind of talk like this. Whether you're a podcaster or a fan, Himalaya's got your back. Discover personally curated playlists and show your favorite podcaster some love with Himalaya's tip jar. This is more like a quip jar over here on this show, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, if you're not on our Patreon, you should quip on over to tip us on the show.
You are not even approaching a sentence right now, bro.
Quippity tippin', bro. You can do it on Himalaya, which is great. We always appreciate that. Yeah.
All right. Okay, Tom, close enough.
Connor was on the road, and then I have a fever, so everyone's working out here.
This
all right. Tell me more, Connor,
this is
please.
A pretty funny ad, to be honest.
Connor,
with you.
Tell me more.
It's the easiest to use, and we're adding cool new... I think this is only supposed to be like 30 seconds. We're adding cool new features every day. Go to your app store, download Himalaya. That's Himalaya for most of our fans.
Yeah, yeah, spelled like the country.
You know what? I think that's that's a Doug Stanhope joke. So sorry, Doug. Like the that's in China for most of my fans. No,
I don't think Himalaya cares about.
No, I'm just saying for comedy fans.
Yeah.
I have integrity, you know, but it was in the moment. It was an accident. Yeah, I owned up to it.
You tell people when you steal. I love it.
But enough about Louis. No, I'm kidding. and don't forget to follow Mean Boys once you're there. It's fucking cool. It's free, easiest to use, lots of features. I think I've read all of this shit. Yeah, but it's cool. I got it open in front of me, and honestly, it's a really nice interface. The Apple podcasting app grows to suck more and more each fucking passing
yeah,
day.
Yeah, I've heard so many of our fans complain about the Apple podcast. It crashes on me all the fucking time.
It crashes, it's slow, it's archaic, and they have the monopoly, and they've gotten lazy. So Himalaya has swooped in, and it's pretty fucking slick. I'm looking at it right now. I got all my podcasts in here. The playlist thing I actually like, because then you could say, like,
yeah,
these are all the episodes with the good Keith's mom stories. They're like, this is these are all the Gareth Reynolds episodes, you know?
Yeah,
this
yeah.
Convenience. Or, like, if I would love to see, like, hey, here's all, you know, Tim Dillon's funniest podcast.
I feel
hell
like
yeah, I'm a guy to 4-hour flight.
Every other podcasting platform is stupid for not already having that feature on it. I think that's a great feature. Yeah, I'm going to use the shit out of that.
Yeah, no, it's totally cool. And and they're supporting the show. And that's how I found out about it, and I just liked it. So that works out great. You get too much transparency here. Anyway, download Himalaya. Give us a follow. And we're actually going to put out the shows a day early on the Monday-ish. We'll do our best. But, yeah, you might get some early shows.
Yeah.
If you follow us on Himalaya... End of ad.
And the Mean Boys podcast is back to take a look at your questions, your Twitters, your emails, all that good shit. It's the Mean Boys mailbag.
It's Mean Boys mailbag. Fuck everything. God is dead. Send us an email or give us a call. Have you ever heard the one about Keith and the dog? It's the motherfucking Mean Boys mailbag.
Yeah, thank you, Andrew Hillary, for our rollicking jingle.
Yeah.
Very much matches the energy of this particular show.
Yeah. We're all in a low energy place today, but I don't think anyone came to the Nicole Buchanan episode for fireworks. You come to chill out and hang out, have a cup of tea.
I don't know whether to find that offensive or not.
I'm sorry, guys. I've been writing award show patter for 48 hours, and it is like my head is fried. And I apologize. So I will take responsibility.
Yeah.
I like to think I'm all fireworks.
No, I was terrorist act. I was building to a compliment,
okay.
but Connor jumped in front of the hate.
You're all fireworks. The smoke bombs, are we talking? You know, staining things.
You're all fireworks and that you're ruining the property value of this neighborhood.
The fireworks that are somehow shaped like a sad face instead of a happy face.
Yeah. At Meaty Gonzalez.
I saw... He tweeted me about something earlier. I've really enjoyed that name.
Says, what name would you give the Mean Boys house, such as Helm's Deep, Fortress of Solitude, Monticello, etc.? If the house had a signature food dish, what would it be?
Well, it already has a name. Ramsey called it the Pacquiao Palace, and we've never really considered an alternate name for it.
Yeah, I mean, you know, named for the possum and the fact that it's in historic Filipino town, which is neither historic nor Filipino.
Yeah, no,
the
possum.
House that Jewel built.
The house that Jewel built?
Like the musician
or the vape?
The vape. The vape.
There we go.
Yeah,
this does look like the kind
this
of
this is the
Jewel
house that Jewel built, y'all.
This is where Jewel would have lived before she got famous. Like,
yeah. No, Ramsey did. When did Ramsey start? I remember the week that Ramsey started vaping was one of the funniest weeks of my life. You know, he just every day he would come home with a new bit that he would do in the kitchen about it.
Yeah,
that was great. I miss the guys living here because especially Ramsey, because every night would just be like you were watching him do panel on the Ramsey Badawi show in the kitchen, you know, and he'd be like, oh yeah. And blah, blah. Anyway, I have enough funny examples, and the story was pointless. But
yeah, so that's the nickname as far as signature food for the house.
Oh God,
I can't imagine a worse hell.
Pre-packaged.
Yeah, I can't.
A jar of peanut butter with a spoon in it.
Dude, our sink is full of something green right now.
Oh God,
I don't know what happened, but I'm not going to solve it.
Yeah, no. Well, everyone, we're at like this weird fucking Cold War situation with the dishes, where it's like nobody has done them. The sink is clogged, and it is full of like Hulk blood,
yeah.
and it's absolutely wretched. It's starting to smell. And
oh, there's no starting, my friend. It's
yeah.
been smelling.
And we all you know, deny culpability, so I think we're just all going to move out.
I think you just leave it exactly as it
I
is.
I think that I don't know that it's ever going to... I've just kind of accepted that I'm going to just have to cram the water bottle down to fill it up on the other side of the sink for the rest of my life.
I'm losing money because I can't fill water bottles up in
Jesus
there anymore.
Christ.
Oh, I'm doing the same thing. Well, how do you think the piss jugs got started?
I was talking to someone the other day that, like, because they just moved in by themselves, and they're like, when you move in by yourself, you realize that you're the problem. Like, you're all going to move in by yourself and be like, oh, yeah, I'm disgusting because the dishes are all, you can't blame them on anyone else.
Right.
I'm going to keep my room pretty nice.
That's why you move in with a significant other and quietly resent them.
Got plenty of energy to keep my room tidy and clean with all, you know, that I'm not burning those unnecessary calories walking to the bathroom.
Me and my boyfriend are children, so we just get paper plates and plastic cups and, you know, then there's no dishes to do. We're killing trees out here.
And then, you know, pretty soon they'll be beachfront property.
Yeah, exactly. Fuck nature.
Yeah.
At Nugs for Christ says, what would y'all do if you got booked to do a Gathering of the Juggalos set? I figured Nicole could contribute as well, being such a fan of Eminem.
Crush is what I would do.
Yeah. I think you would either have the greatest set in recorded comedy history or be murdered. Like,
I've done more with less.
Like, you
look, I'm not a very good comedian. I'm the best comedian to book on a bad gig.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, if it is a horrible situation, I am extraordinarily professional.
That is awesome.
Very nice show. I have no idea what to do.
Are they offering to book us?
No, although it's been bandied about.
Because I would do the shit out of that
show.
Oh,
as would I.
I
can't think of a greater
honor.
The
only person that emails into my podcast at this point, it's a very new podcast, is a juggalo, and he's a super fan. He's got his mom on board. His mom listens to the show and tweets at us.
Oh, yeah, that guy was rad, man. He brought us Faygo, because I guess the juggalos we met last time brought us the bad Faygo.
And then we did the most juggalo shit you could do, which was shoot crossbows at the Faygo.
Oh, we did, yeah.
Yeah, I ended up drinking... what is it? Cotton candy Faygo out of a bullet wound in a Faygo bottle.
But what does being an Eminem fan have to do with juggling?
They're both
like it's a good Venn diagram of.
They're both
white
from
nonsense.
Detroit. You know, it's like weed isn't really like a gateway drug to crack, but it's like, you know, if you smoke crack, you probably tried weed first kind of a thing with Eminem and them. Okay. The Faygo was a funny addition because that was during my Hunter S. Thompson van trip where I was going insane and I thought I was trapped in a computer simulation. And it was funny just to be holding a bottle of Faygo going, is this real?
Who programmed the Faygo?
Taking a drink and I'm like, well, I hope so because it's actually pretty good.
Who ran program Faygo.exe? EXE.
I know, yeah. Like, when did they get around to this? I mean, physics must have taken up a good amount of time, but really, the patch updates on this shit is really, it's really astounding.
Yeah. We got an email here. They asked to be anonymous, but the subject line is pretty great. My ex is doing stand-up about stalking me.
Nice.
Whoa.
So it says, hi, Mean Boys. As a fan of the show, I wanted to share something with you guys I'm currently dealing with. Last year, I took my ex to your show in Pittsburgh. It was both of our first live comedy experiences. I broke up with him shortly after, and things have gotten pretty bad over the past year. Basically, he's been harassing me after I told him not to contact me. Recently, he sent me a link to a YouTube video. He did an entire open mic routine about me and our breakup. He even brought up cyberstalking me, and people in the audience laughed about it. I'm just speechless at this point. I don't really know what I can do about it. What are your thoughts on this? What is the best way to deal with an ex that won't give up? Anyways, love the show. Fuck everything. God is dead.
It's like when George Harrison found out about the Manson murders, and he's like, I was just writing a song about pigs. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like I was really, I was just kind of trying to call these two specific guys fat.
I honestly would not worry about it at all.
I mean, first off, genuine piece of housekeeping.
First of all, don't listen to Nicole.
No, if that guy is listening, though, to this show,
oh, yeah,
presumably they're some sort of fan, maybe, fucking stop it.
Yeah, fuck you.
Yeah.
Cut it out.
Yeah, you're a dick.
Yeah, that's not cool at
it
all.
It is weird that he said
unless
it.
The bit's really good. Now, yeah. if the set was funny,
say.
I mean,
yeah.
Will it kill it, Flappers? Because if it will...
Yeah.
Well, the fact that he sent it to her is weird, but I do want to say, like, define cyber stalking. Like, do you mean that he looks at your Instagram every once in a while, or?
I mean, it sounds like, I mean, I gave you all the information I have, mm-hmm. but it seems like this guy is making contact and like being harassy. And
that's... by the way, you know you're cyber stalking too far when you get to the Google Plus page, you know, and you're like, maybe they used this for a week and there's some stuff
yeah,
I haven't seen.
If you were doing something online, whether it was just liking my post or whatever, and I told you to stop it and then you kept doing it, you're an asshole. Like,
that is true.
Really a gray area. If somebody tells you not to do a fucking thing and you do it to bum him out, you're a piece of shit.
Yeah, I mean, definitely block that guy. Block the shit out of him.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe go private for a while, you know, let the heat die down.
Yeah, that would
just
be my
move. Annoying, but
I wouldn't I wouldn't engage with it a ton just because it's the only kind of way, you know, it's the starve him out kind of thing.
Yeah, I would, you know, I would look into blocking his number so you can't, you know, receive anything from him. You know, I'm sure he's probably got your email, which is that's where a lot of times you end up going, and I don't know what resources are available and cutting him off there, but I wouldn't worry about him being a famous comedian or anything. I think he'll be all right with that. But I just would just don't give him anything. You know, that sucks. I'm sorry that you're doing that. I'm especially sorry that it's you know, just tangentially related to this show.
Although it
sounds
like she was the one who brought him. She was the fan, if anything else. So.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
Hopefully, he doesn't listen to us at all, and you're just cool, lady.
I'm sorry that happened.
Yeah.
Because now I feel bad about. I used to feel bad about how much fun Connor and Keith had in Pittsburgh because of Tom, and now I got to add another lady that.
Pittsburgh will be our guiltiest
equation.
Best day ever.
Yeah, where Tom was like, I'm going to have a beer for my birthday. And we're like, yeah, we'll celebrate it with you. And then Connor's playing pool, hitting on a girl. Keith is in the parking lot. And Tom is just drinking alone on his birthday.
Yeah, shoving off interested women while he watches a hockey game he doesn't like.
Yeah, surrounded by people he doesn't know, rooting for a team he doesn't like, and a city he's never been to all by himself.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry, lady.
Yeah, that sucks.
That fucking sucks.
Sounds like a dweeb.
Have you ever been stalked, Nicole? You've been harassed for sure. What was? Do you have any techniques, advice, or even just emotional strategies to cope with the pressure of it?
It feels really violating, especially. I remember the first time I was really stalked was in high school. I used to pick my friend up every day because I could drive and she couldn't yet. And there was this guy that was like across the street in his car every time. And we thought he was just like a neighbor who was picking someone up every time. And so we would like wave to him because we saw him every day and he was just there. And we figured he was just like a guy. And then one day he left like a note on my car that said that we were like his two flowers in the garden of life. And that like every time he saw us, it like prevented him from killing himself. Because...
even worse, you're being stalked by a hack. Flowers in the garden of life.
Yeah, well, he was, he definitely wasn't the cool, like, well, he's a stalker. Like, what do you expect? He's going to be like fucking weird.
Yeah, there's not a lot of rad ones.
Yeah, he's not a poet. It was like on a napkin in Sharpie. And then me and my friend like freaked out. We went to school and we brought the napkin to like our like school counselor or whatever, because we were freaked out. We're like, I don't know if he follows us to school, like he's there every morning. And they laughed at us.
Jesus.
And
whoa.
They were like, haven't you heard of stranger danger? Like, why did you take this note? And I was like, he left it on my car, like I didn't have a choice. And like
I had to see the driving I was about to do.
She's being a bitch about it. And then
I don't know, my thing rhymes, so it's your fault.
And then like my friend's mom called them and like chewed them out for it. And then the police and the vice principal showed up to my class and pulled me out of class. And he was like, I'm sorry, my secretary's a fucking idiot, basically.
Whoa.
And then Yeah, and then the police were like, we can't do anything until he actually like does something. And I was like, so he can just stalk me? But then like he kept showing up, and so eventually the police showed up and told him like, hey, you can't be around these girls anymore. Right. And then he stopped showing up, and it just, when I like, it just,
well, sounds like everybody learned their lesson.
Yeah.
It was, it does feel really violating. And again, I'm sorry. And I have also had an ex that wouldn't leave me alone when I told them to leave me alone. And that sucks too. So I feel for you. And the best advice I can give is just to block them as much as possible. And, fuck, I don't know. Try to just live your life. But it is very violating. And the fact that he sent that to you means he wants you to know he's stalking you. And that's like a power move. And that sucks. And
yeah.
Yeah, he's just throwing stuff at the wall, trying to get it to stick. But, you know, you, you dear listener, I could tell you're Teflon. It's not going to work on you. Bring a little coach energy to this. Huh?
Yeah,
it's fun.
Yeah.
That's, you know, that's whatever.
You miss 100% of the dicks you don't block.
Yeah, sure.
Definitely don't react or respond, because that's giving him what he wants. Even if you want to be angry, like angrily respond, because I wanted to do that.
Although it would be funny to just use the iMessage feature and just give it a ha-ha reaction.
But any type of response at all is what he's going for. So even if you feel like you're angry or sad or whatever, don't give him the time of day, you know?
Yeah, maybe don't, you know, ask a question about it on a podcast he might listen to.
Because
This may not be that anonymous.
Yeah, because...
probably should have led with that.
Yeah, I guess get fucked, shithead, if you think this is you.
I know,
that's
just
true.
Kidding.
If you don't know this is you, but you think it's you, fuck you anyway. You did something else bad.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody was like, oh, I was stalking some other girl.
Oh, he was like, Carol, congratulations, you got on the show. That, I just made that name up, by the way. She's like, no, that wasn't me. And we're like, oh, looks like we got a real, the old Rick and Morty conundrum brewing over here.
This one's from Mike Beach. He says, hi, Mean Boys, just a quick question. I just bought Keith's album and liked it a lot. And from what I understand of stand-up, it takes about 6 months to a year to put together enough material for a set. A little longer than that.
Yeah.
While I enjoyed the album a lot, I also never laughed as hard as I did at Jimbo Kimbo, which was a complete accident. Do you guys have any feelings when material that you've worked on for a long time doesn't hit as hard as something that's a complete accident? Keep on trucking.
Well, I don't have any material, so I
literally 2 hours of
material. I only do accidents. No, yeah, it's always way more fun. I that's why I just mess around, right? Because I don't really. It's a lot. It's always more, you know, exciting, you know?
Yeah, there is.
It's kind of the only time I really feel much of a rush anymore doing it.
Have you guys ever tried to, like, recreate an accident that hits really hard?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, and it never works.
Quite pans out.
I have some bits where I'll kind of try and work in, like, the road I took to get to an accident to try and find the thing. But,
yeah.
Like, it always feels a little inauthentic. It never has the magic of the first time.
Well, I had this bit where I was saying I was a 10-year-old girl. But, like, I added, like, an extra fucking in. Like, you know, when you're talking, you're like, fucking. So I was like, I was fucking a 10-year-old girl. And then I was like, wait, no, I was a fucking 10-year-old. I wasn't fucking a 10-year-old girl.
No, I was a 10-year-old girl that was fucking.
I've tried to recreate that. And it works sometimes. Other times it doesn't. But I always feel stupid doing that because it's not as genuine as it was the first time, you know?
Yeah, I did that too. But it was a kid. I said I was telling a story about someone. So I was like, you know, my buddy Greg's fucking this kid, right? And I was like, oh, no, that was, he didn't do that. And then I was telling the story, like, with him, I was telling his story, you know what I mean? And he was like, yo! It was Opie.
Yeah, you gotta be careful where you put your fuckings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't put them in a kid.
No, don't put your fuckings in a kid now.
Anyway, going down to Cracker Barrel.
We were having a party the other day for a buddy of ours that was in town, a little get-together with all the guys, and we didn't really, you know, really just a small little get-together. We just watched a lot of YouTube Denny's fights, and then I started showing him Louis Theroux clips, and then we're all watching this documentary about pedophiles for like 20 minutes in silence, getting sad, and I was like, I'm not good at conducting the party.
I like the idea of that set to I Got a Feeling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just chips and dip. Nobody's touching, you know?
Tonight's the night.
Yeah, I literally can't stop myself no matter how hard I try. Small swig of IPA. Look around room. Back to screen. No escape.
Well, I think that's it.
Yeah, I think that is. Nicole, thanks for coming on the show. Listen to the Screw Ups podcast, everybody.
Please do. Yeah. It's, that's my podcast with my good friend Jesse Johnson, and we interview people about their biggest screw ups in life. It's a fun time.
That's it.
Yeah.
Someone, I think, maybe confessed to what might have been a crime recently.
Oh, no.
Whoa. Hey, you want to tease that a little more? What kind of crime are we talking?
So he was talking about how he was trying to get pussy after a show.
Oh, this is not going to be.
Is going to be a fun one or a really
might,
bad
might not be a very funny kind of
it's
a crime.
It's something maybe Keith can relate to.
Okay, so Nicole just told the rest of that story. We just had to edit out. So that was that was why there was an edit point there.
But the rest of the stories are mostly You screw up. The point of the podcast is you screw up and then you forgive yourself and you move on. Usually it makes you a better person or it brings you to where you are today. But that one might have been a crime. So
yeah, that is definitely a crime.
Check
what is this might of?
Yeah. That's somebody
know.
That happened to. That's really not an okay thing to do.
Where is the gray area in that sea of blackness?
But you turned out okay.
It's debatable.
Oh, good. The Twitch is back. Anyway, that's it for me, boys.
Maybe cut that out. Listen to Screw's podcast.
Yeah, do that.
Yeah.
All right. Bye.